Hi, Manu. We'll be starting shortly. I'm just tweaking a couple of things and getting myself a coffee. Yeah, I might have been up a bit later than expected last night playing Warcraft. So I need a boost. I'm liking it. Like, I'm taking my time with all the quests and stuff and doing a bit of exploring. And there's a lot of like new stuff they've added in that nobody's ever seen before. So the previous expansions we've been going after enemies we knew about. And then everything we're seeing at the moment is entirely new. So I'm enjoying looking around and finding stuff out and seeing what's in all the new areas and stuff. Right, let's make a start, shall we? Because we have a decision to make first as well. Because we've got an option of two hospitals to move to next. We have Mitten University, home to some of the brightest minds in Two Point County. It may be chilly, but it's also the perfect place for us to start developing some new technology. Mitten University Research and Training Hospital. Teaching Hospital, I should say. Hi, Drew. So with it being a teaching hospital, it means we'll get student doctors and things like that that we'll have to train up. Or we can go to Tumble. We'll treat all manner of breaks and bruises in a subalpine playground. The county's home for hiking, fishing and falling down. So this means there's going to be loads of breaks and things like that. Yeah, breaks and bruises. Well, what do you guys think I should go? Should I go to the training hospital, where we're going to teach people to do the job? Or should we go for the breaks and falls? Hey Sam. We're currently trying to decide which hospital to do next. Do we do Tumble for breaks and bruises? Or do we do Mitten University for teaching people? Manu can't seem to make their mind up at the moment, so I'll leave it up to Sam. You reckon uni, Manu? Off the university then, shall we? Oh, Imperial College, nice. So that's the one in Cambridge, isn't it? If I'm remembering right. So we are at Mitten University. The Vice Chancellor of Mitten University has been impressed with our progress and we've been invited to establish Mitten University Research and Teaching Hospital. This is a great opportunity for us. We can set up a research department and develop some new tech. We'll only be able to recruit student doctors and nurses here, so we'll need to train them up. Mayton University will provide us with extra funds for each person we train and each research project we complete. Firstly though, we'll need a research license. The ministry will grant us one if we can demonstrate our technical prowess by establishing a hospital with some upgraded machinery. So, pause this first. Some parts of the county are quite cold or too hot. We'll need to keep the people comfortable by ensuring they're warm enough, but also not too warm. If people are too cold or too hot, they can become unhappy and may eventually leave. In cold locations, place radiators around the hospital. In hot locations, we'll need air conditioning. Use a temperature visualization mode to identify cold and hot areas of the hospital. And thanks for the fellow, Sam. No worries. Like, I always save the streams afterwards, so if you want to have a look later, you can come back to the channel. So let's see how cold this place is. Was the temperature one on? There. Yeah, it's all light blue, so it's going to be a cold place. So, first of all, we have a reception we can build now. Like, we have an actual reception. So, slap one down here. You are not central. There. Yeah, I do have a thing about having them kind of equal on both sides. There's our entrance hatch. I think we can get have one on each side, shall we? So we can have three. We can fit three receptionists in here. Give them a little filing cabinet to store their stuff in. Unless it's like my filing cabinet at work, where it's just filled with snacks and sweets. Like, literally, my desk at work is, I have three drawers. The top drawer has my notes in, the middle drawer has stationery, and the bottom drawer is just filled with sweets and similar. And no pills in it at the moment, I had to bring them all home. Give them a coffee machine. And the all-important plant. And a radiator, because this is a cold hospital. What else can we get then? We got a bit of money to play around with. Yeah, when I was back in work Manu, my desk was the stop for snacks. I would regularly get people coming over going, got any crisps? Got any biscuits? Need a biscuit. So I just dig through the drawer and hand them something. So, there we go, we'll get a charity pot so people can donate their pennies. Yeah, my desk was the snack spot, and I shouldn't really tell people, but it was the hideout spot as well. So people would come to me with questions about stuff. And they do it quite often. So what I used to do is, if someone was having a rough day or someone, I would send them a message and say, like, just come over here and chill for a bit and pretend you're asking me a question. I didn't do it too often, but every now and then somebody just come over and go, I'm having a crap day, I'm just going to hide out for a bit. Get them some flowers as well. A cove. We are just starting to set up in our university hospital. There's our reception area. Got them some plants and some coffee. Some nice flowers and some storage. So we need assistance. You're pretty well qualified, but they're nasty. No. Person has dirty habits. This person likes to argue. Right, we'll take the dirty habits one because we can fix that with janitors. So, psychiatry, we can get a training room straight off, so let's build some GP's offices and a training room. How wide is this area? 9. So, yeah, 3x3. We'll try it that way. Oh wait, how? 10. If I have... Nah, we'll leave it as 3x3. Hi, Sherry. So, sort out a GP's office, give them the all-important hand sanitizer, and everybody's getting a coffee machine today. Give them a book place as well to make it look a bit neater. And a plant. And we'll give them a fancy rug. One GP's office. Maybe we can bump up the level of the room a bit with some nice stuff. You need a gnome. Everybody needs a gnome. Hand sanitizer and gnomes. Gnomes go everywhere. Oh, invalid for the room, so I can't put one in the reception. Oh well. Notice board up behind his desk. Some drawings from visiting children. Some of that looks a bit like Div Chen's drawings. Like, I'm sure that one says there, says I done a poo. That looks definitely like something Div Chen would draw. What else? We need a radiator, don't we? This is the cold hospital. Where can I sneak a radiator in? We fit one there? Yeah. Radiator. Get him a lamp. A nice lamp right in the centre of the room. And we'll stick a couple of posters up. So, have a nice anatomy poster in case he forgets where stuff is. Another one for the brain, for the same reason. We'll stick a food pyramid in. There we go, that'll do for now. So there's one GP's office. And we will be lazy and do it this way. 5 invalid items, that's the windows and a couple of posters. For some reason, whenever you put a poster down, it deletes it when you put a room next door, despite it still being valid. So, let's put those two back in. Most of the drawings he tends to delete when they're done with them. I'm sure he's kept some when people have asked, but share to him next stream and find out. He should keep them, really. All-important training room in, so you can be slightly bigger because we don't really need anybody waiting around outside this. Yeah, definitely on his Discord, or just keep them in general. Like, so he's got a stash of them if he ever wants them for anything. before we put it in the bin. We need a plant. Now we need a radiator, because this is a cold hospital. I need to keep reminding myself, otherwise I'll forget. That sounds like the perfect drawing, Sherry. What else can we put in here? Trophy case. Are there any stuff that helps with teaching? I'm sure there is. Anti-paintings, clocks. More chocolate, drinking fountain. Anatomy model, yeah, we'll get one of those. We used to have one of these when I went to school, and nobody could ever put it back together again. A jungle room, I might do that for the staff room. So I'm sure I can swap stuff around to make it look a bit like a jungle. A brain in a jar as well. Can it even fit in here? Yes, it can. There we go, brain in a jar. Training room's done. So, we've got two GP rooms. I suppose we should hire some doctors. And these are all trainees, so this level, none of them will have any qualifications. So we've got this guy who's inspiring and positive. Whoops. So Penelope Chess, we will have her. Weak bladder and metaphysically disgruntled. And thinks that life is, we'll have those too. Yeah, but that's not really a surprising comment for Manu either. Oh, drop a pharmacy down here. We'll give the pharmacist a coffee maker, they need it. I know at least one pharmacist and she's constantly drinking coffee. I am saying that that comment is not out of character for something you'd say, Manu. So we've got a pharmacy. What other rooms do we need? We need a ward, general diagnosis, cardiology, psychiatry, and we need a staff room and toilets. So we'll put the staff room and toilets down that end. Go for... let's build the ward here. We should still have the pods unlocked as well, so... you there, get rid of you, have these. There we go, pods. Put some windows in so everybody can see you while you're sleeping and getting changed. I will try and remember the toilets this time at some point. Money creatures in. Fire extinguisher. Plant. And I just remembered I forgot a radiator for in here. Radiator for the pharmacist. And we'll need at least two radiators in here because it's quite a big room. We'll put one there and I'll see if I can put one. Can't fit it next to the desk. Tell you what, put you on the end wall, shall we? Can you fit there? No. Do a little bit of rearranging. There. Radiator there. Radiator there. That should be that room sorted. So, nurses, litterer, green fingers, unmotivated, hygienic, boring. Once more money. We'll get Jasper for now because he's going to help water our plants as well. And we're going to pick between these two. Unmotivated, but he's hygienic and he's boring. He just wants extra money. Bugger it. It's all about the money. So what have we got left? We need... Got a reception, GP's phone. So we need general diagnosis, cardiology, psychiatry, staff room and toilets, and then the three clinics. What size do these need to be? 3x3, 3x3. 3x3, 4x4, 4x4. Right, let's start with the diagnosis ones first. Punching bag in there. Cardiology sorted. General diagnosis. Scanner and bed. Need a plant. I forgot a radiator for that room, didn't I? Need to keep remembering the radiator. There. And one for this room as well. Machine in here as well. There we go. So this is the sense we'll get at least one janitor. There we go. And it's about time we opened up shop as well. So let's get going. Do we need any? So, this is the temperature map and it's looking alright at the moment. This hospital is massive. I did not realise we started with, we could get all this room, so. Buy this ready. You could actually do that in the original game, Alex. Like, if you didn't want to buy janitors to save money, you could plonk a bench down on top of mess, sell it immediately for full price, and it would delete the mess. You could also do it with benches and patients you didn't like. It would occasionally accidentally delete the patient as well. Unfortunately, Bullfrog went bust as well, so they never got the chance to patch it. So I think it got fixed in a fan patch eventually. There we go. Stick a couple of radiators down, keep everybody nice and toasty. Right. Time for more plants and a couple of gnomes, so keep us there. Put a gnome here. And one by this door. So plants. Make the place pretty. So yeah, this is like the, I think they call it the beauty map or something like that. Basically just shows you how nice your hospital looks. Oh. Boom.
Patients are not permitted to sleep in ward beds. We're busy. Recover at home.
Right, I would do Sherry, but the auto mob thing annoys me because they tend to be really jumpy, and I just can't be bothered configuring it for all the stuff. Right. Research license, yay! So, great news! Two Point Health Ministry has granted us research license. This will allow any of our hospitals to research new machines, upgrades and more. To kick off a research project, we'll need a research room and a doctor with a research qualification. Diagnosis and treatment of patients can also contribute to research progress. Harvesting ghosts can also be very enlightening. So, we will be able to rebuild a research room quite soon. So we need benches for people to sit down at. Start adding these in. And I'll add in some vending machines for people as well. Bin, even though the buggers will never use it. There we go. Psychiatry still, even though we've not actually got a psychiatrist yet.
Please keep audio on at all times. Thank you.
There There we go. So we need his armchair and the couch for the patient to lie on. Filing cabinet for records and a bin. Where's the radiator before I forget? Why can't I see the radiator? Am I blind? Nope, just went past it. There. Pull out a rug in. Use the gnome because he can have one. And he needs some plants. Where has plants gone? There. There we go. We have a psychiatrist. Now we actually need to build this training room, otherwise we're not going to be able to do anything, so... Oh no, we've got the training room, haven't we? So we need to train a psychiatrist. I tend to have a build order for things. Like, I'll always try and get diagnosis stuff in straight away, along with the pharmacy. But beyond that, I'll add in stuff like the plans lab and the deluxe clinic and stuff like that as they're needed. So I've got all the diagnosis stuff now. Got cardiology, got a ward, got psychiatry, and a psychiatrist being trained. Don't need any of those yet, but I do need staff room and toilets, which can go here.
George Bristles, who sent in this quote: "If at first you fail, be thankful that you have friends. Watching them fail too will make you feel better." He's right, you know.
Make them 4x4, shall we? So, toilets. Yeah, occasionally there'll be some things where it's like, you'll need it urgently for that hospital, so I'll try and get that done first. So, like, once I've got these two built, I am putting the research centre in. Oh, someone died.
The fauna are reminded not to disturb the flora. Right.
We need a gnome and a bin.
Nurse needed in general diagnosis.
What did he get rid of? Got rid of one of the toilets. Why did that happen? Right, I just need to modify a couple of Discord settings to get it sorted. Oh, let's get another janitor. This guy can even deal with ghosts. And we can deal with the grumpy janitor, he'll do. Stat staff room was next, wasn't it? Yay! Oh, cool! We got money for training people. Right. We shall be doing a lot more training then. Because that was 5 grand and that's easy money. Machines. We'll give them a coffee machine as well. Some plants. Bookcase. And a gnome. In fact, 2 gnomes for in here. Staff room. And then some rope.
Patients are reminded to avoid death when possible.
There. Right, what do they want? He wants training. So Josh Fiddle already has lots of experience as a junior nurse. Right, we'll train you up on injection room. We don't have that yet, so I will ignore that. Ward management, always useful. We can, Sherry. Do you want to be one at doctors? Clown circus incident. No, bugger off. Don't have the clown room yet. Radiator, where are you? There.
Nurse needed.
Yeah, I forgot the radiators again. Oh, I've gotten quite high body counts before. But yeah, show us Alex, let's see what it's like. So, heating looks fine, we need more plants. Plant here. Plant here. No, plant here. New illness, misery guts discovered. Our doctors have discovered a new illness, misery guts. Chronic grumpiness due to a nihilistic semicolon. We'll send the patient for treatment in our pharmacy. There. Stick some more benches down. Basic little hospital. We don't have a gyno department or a gyno department at the moment, Sherry. I can make you the psychiatrist if you want. We could just train psychiatrist. All the nurses gone on break together. Get another nurse anyway.
Doctor to psychiatry, please.
Inspiring, nasty, Positive and hungry has potential. We'll get the one with potential, shall we? Right, psychologist. There you go, Dr. Darksherry.
Fear not, dear listeners, for Sir Nigel Bickleworth has arrived to elevate your radio experience beyond the mundane.
We shall give you a costume so you can stand out a bit.
But first, a piece of music.
There you go, you can be Scammer Sherry in disguise.
Nurse required a general diagnosis.
Staff promotion. Yes, always worth promoting staff. And the VIP wants to visit. So I'll be back in a second. I'm just going to get another drink. You can watch and see if anybody dies.
I shall be visiting the Old Croc Museum in Sweaty Palms later this week. I sincerely hope they have corrected the multiple cases of mislabeled geodes I spotted last time. Speaking of museums, I believe this next song belongs in one.
I have returned. Yeah, I went to get a drink, so good here. Staff promotion. Cure 10 patients. So we've made Sherry our psychologist. Wherever he's gone. Here we go.
Maintenance needed.
Scammer Sherry in disguise. So we need. Oh, someone else is dead. Need more staff, really. Let's get at least one more doctor. Motivated. Yeah, you'll do. Here we go. We'll go for 4 of each. Charming and knows where the party is at. Half clown, high energy. Stupid, no, we're not having you. Positive and motivated, yes. Nurses. Nasty, no. Positive and angry. Nasty. Yeah, we'll have the Tyler's romantic in. We can make you one, Alex. We're about to do some training with them. So you can actually pick. So, next bit of training we need. Trainees available. We will pick Dr. Rampant. What do you want to be good at, Alex? We've got psychiatry, diagnostics, research. These are all just like boosters for stamina and stuff. You could be a GP, or you could be I forgot what the name is, for somebody who does treatment on its own. Make Alex a GP then, shall we? Need to rename the doctor wherever they've gone. Staff. There we go. And we will give you fancy outfit. What do you want? Viking or wizard? I'll give you a choice. Wizard it is then.
Attention. Urinating anywhere in the hospital will not be tolerated.
Oh look, Manu. Look what someone's done. Right on the floor. Dirty bastards. Right, so what was I doing? Research room. That's what I needed next. But you can be the entirety of this bit. So we have a great big research desk. And I'm sure we can have more than one of these. Let's move things around a bit. You're the pod where they put stuff. There. Windows.
I'm hearing that cabinet. Augustus Lavender, the CEO of Holistics,
fire extinguisher in case any of it gets overloaded. Today,
no doubt offered to
spray. These guys are definitely going to need
coffee. As if natural remedies.
We'll give them one each,
because
I'm going to put two researchers in there eventually. The all-important plants to make it look pretty. We'll give them a brain in a jar, shall we? Sounds like the kind of thing a researcher would need. And what else do we have? Radiator. Need at least one radiator in here, keep them warm a bit. Can we afford anything fancy for it? Not at the moment. So, for now, this room. I don't have enough for the room yet. No.
Nurse, please go to the pharmacy.
We'll get rid of one of these until we can afford a second. Start research project. either click on the research pod or drop a researcher into the room. Sherry, for it to be Manu's brain, she has to have had one in the first place. So, start research project, either click on the pod or drop a researcher in the room. Once it's started, you'll need a doctor with a research qualification. Research is shared across the whole organisation as the discoveries we make. You can start a project in one hospital and continue work on it in another. We have a mock star emergency. We'll get Sherry to do that. We can't do chromotherapy yet, so this person can go home. We're at 3 staff, 1 done. Get them to wait. So we need to train a researcher, and I think we should make Manu the researcher. Where's one of our other doctors? Student doctor. Are you there? And you can be our researcher. But I don't have enough cash at the moment, so we're going to have to wait a little bit. New illness, mock star discovered. Doctors have discovered a new illness, mock star. Patients believe themselves to be one of the greatest rock stars the world has ever seen, but are sadly gaga. That's only because it's the first time at this hospital. Oh yeah, she can research new ways to kill patients. She can grind patients up in case we can't cure them. She can even capture ghosts, Ghostbuster style, and stick them in a box to research. So now we have Dr. Manu, who is going to be our researcher. You need an outfit, but I'm going to give you a choice. You can either be the penguin, or you can have the horny helmet. It's your decision. Horny helmet it is. There you are. Dr. Manu, soon to be researcher. Time for the yearly review. Definitely not going to get that no deaths award.
Maintenance announcement. Automated snack machines need restocking manually.
So, let's see what we get. Rising star goes to Jasper Fiddle. Employer of the year goes to me. No deaths goes to some other shitty hospital. Best teaching hospital goes to other shitty hospitals. Patient's choice is other shitty hospital. Right, let's see what it is. No, I didn't win anything else. Rubbish. No more awards for us. Right, I I've got enough money, let's train Manu as a researcher quick.
Hungry.
And we will change Manu's duties. So she only does research.
Eat some cheesy gubbins. Cheesy gubbins. The snack for people with nothing to lose.
This is too. Yeah, Sherry, do you want to join the hospital? I'm sure we've still got another doctor left.
Maintenance announcement. Baths need water.
Yeah. Be a doctor, you can be a nurse, be a janitor. Your pick. Yeah, Sherry is already our psychiatrist. I feel sorry for those patients already. New illness, potty mouth discovered. When a patient opens their mouth, terrible things happen caused by drinking water from a toilet sink or a toilet. Right, so... let's get a new doctor. Right, so we still need the Deluxe Clinic, we still need the Clown Clinic, we still need the PANS Lab, so those three can go in here.
Doctor to psychiatry, please.
Four by four. Build this one first. Extinguisher. And a bin. All important plants.
In today's Sir Nigel Review,
I cast
a critical eye on
Grottle
Bay's most exclusive nightclub, the Cobra Banana. At least I thought
it was a clinic required. Get patient to wait. I am building
class,
one now.
Elegance and a lounge jazz band. Instead, I got youthful, sweaty.
$5,000 for completion of some training. Noise. That means Manu is now our researcher. Come here, you. Go in there and do research. So we will do chromotherapy first.
Maintenance announcement. Toilets need routine service.
And Manu should only be allowed to do research. There we go. Get them to wait. Do some more training in the meantime. Psychiatry 2, Sherry. Costs us $20,000. Alex GP2 $20,000 again. So who else needs training? Need a nurse. Let's have put in the pharmacy for $15,000, so I still need more money. Time to start treating more patients. We are doing all right so far. I might have a look at that in a bit, Sherry. Is it one of the glitch speedruns, or is it like they've got to do it legitimately once? Hi, Bart. We have been adding people to the hospital. Do you want to join? So far we have Manu, who is our researcher, Alex, who is our specialist GP, Sherry, who is our psychiatrist, got these two, one guy working in GP, or you can be a nurse. We've got a ward specialist nurse, or you can even be a janitor. We've got a ghost busting janitor as well. It's your pick. So we'll make Bart the nurse then, shall we? Cancel this off. So, nurses, do you want to be our ward specialist, or do you want to be one of these? Like, one of them's going to be deal with the, whatever the room is called that I've forgotten the name of. We hand out drugs. Pharmacist. So we can make you a pharmacist, hand out drugs and everything to people. Or you can be a ward nurse, or you could just be a general nurse if you want. We shall train you up as a pharmacist soon then. So, and we can give you a costume as well. So, you can either be a Roman legionnaire or a pirate. Which do you want to be? Pirate it is then. Oh. You are the pirate nurse and we will train you up as a pharmacist. Oh. Pharmacy management. Nurse lazy psycho. Go. So you need chromotherapy, you can go home because we don't have that yet. Deal up the clinic, get them to wait. So, Delux clinic.
Maintenance
need water. I did that wrong. Why do I keep doing that? Windows, bin, plants. Everyone needs plants. We need hand sanitizer. Third plant will do. Hand sanitizer. Need a fire extinguisher in case it decides to explode. And radiator. I keep forgetting the bloody radiator. There. Brain anatomy. You can go home, we don't have that yet. So,
this is Nigel Bickleworth.
Yeah, plants are very important. Always.
One must put up with so many offensive inventions these days. Pure travesties that belittle all of humanity. But I ask you, pork pies?
Plants and gnomes, but unfortunately we can't put gnomes in every room, so I just dot them around where I can. So we have our deluxe room, we have our extractor pan. We need to build the clown room at some point.
Maintenance announcement. Bins will become full.
Almost done. Health inspector. Yeah, they can come. Still need the clown room. Research project complete. Well done, we've completed a research project. The discovery can be used across the whole organisation. So that means anything a researcher can now use in other hospitals as well. That'll come in handy. But when a project is completed, researchers will look for work elsewhere unless we kick off another project. As we make new discoveries and travel to new parts of the county, our boffins will propose new areas research. Keep your eyes peeled for new projects. So, do fluid analysis. So these are all diagnosis, I think. Design a machine to extract a range of fluids from patients for diagnosis for diagnostic purposes primarily, but also just for fun. Got an injection room. Design a machine capable of injecting patients without having to touch them. They are filthy after all. Well, this is actually a curing room. X-ray. After Bungle Tech's discovery of V-rays and W-rays, which only vaporize one in every 100 patients, scientists have speculated on the possible existence of an X-ray. This could revolutionize diagnosis, or we can research making Manu a better researcher. I think go for it for fluid analysis. It only takes 1,000 points. We'll go for that first. Our doctors have discovered a new illness, mucky feet. Feet so grubby that the filth will never come out, spreads germs like wildfire. We'll send the patient for treatment in our ward. And we got somebody who wants a promotion. And we have done our challenge. Manu challenges us to promote 3 staff and we're done. So, Bart is now a pharmacist. Specialised. So we still need to do more training. Not really, Sherry. like, with that many viewers, you'd expect the chat to be absolutely spamming it. Unless he's got it set to like a restricted mode or something. Who else needs training? Let's make Alex an even better GP. There. And we will build a clown room. Circus lights and a couple of hay bales scattered around for doing stunts over. And we need the extinguisher in case things explode. All important plants. I'd expect his chat to be absolutely mental. Like, there's a couple of people that I watch that have, like, sometimes have 1,000 viewers. Their chat is, like, completely unfollowable. Right. Don't seem to have any shortages on rooms. So, let's make the bit. Place a bit prettier again. Radiator first.
Anyone who has engaged in any sort of social interaction of late will be aware that there is a severe lack of good manners in our fair county. Since our education system seems incapable of fixing this problem, I entreat you to listen to my Sir Nigel's Guide to Good Manners series. Perhaps I alone can stem the tide of incivility.
Are you reckoning it's virtual machines, Alex? Of entertainment for people, some leaflet stands.
Doctor needed in GP's office. Here
we go, another 5 grand for completing research. Almost done his training. You need chromotherapy, you can go home because we don't have that yet. All depends how good it is, Sherry. I'll make Sherry a slightly better psychiatrist. Can't even do that yet. Training is available there. Psychiatry 2. There you. Incredibly mediocre. No features that sway the overall product, yada yada yada. He wasn't that impressed with the hospital. Does need cleaning up a bit. Pick some more entertainment in, shall we?
You've just won another Grand Point final! How do you do it?
Well, I couldn't do it without my cheesy gubbins.
Cheesy gubbins.
Cheesy Gubbins, the answer to every question.
More 2 Point, more often. This is 2 Point Radio.
Got people standing around as well. Time for more benches. So we just need to cure a patient in chromotherapy now, which means we just need to wait for Manu to finish researching. About a third of the way there. So, what else do we have in the meantime? Oh, we have chromotherapy. Need 21 grand. We just need to save money.
Plants need water.
Money is getting quite low. He wants us to get a loan, but we're not going to do that. Right, let's see if we can't prioritize these. There.
We ought to give thanks each day that our humble little county has attracted such giants of industry as Jumbo and some of these new upstarts. It is to these brave companies I dedicate the following song.
Staff challenge, earn 100,000. It's not likely to happen, but we'll try. Staff training required. You're gonna have to wait a little bit. We might need another GP's office, you know. 20 people waiting. Yeah, we'll stick another one in. And through the magic of copy and paste, we have another GP's office. Down the queues a little bit. Staff training required, not yet. I think we need another janitor as well, we've only got two at the moment. Dirty habits. Cheese for brains. Has potential, you will do. I don't get anybody waiting to be checked in though, so we're good there. Don't need any more assistance yet. New illness, head crabbedness discovered. So far his head has been seized by a rare form of parasitic crustacean. Fortunately a treatment is available that wrenches the creature from the victim, leaving their head healthy and uninfected. Not yet. So what else do we need?
Doctor required in psychiatry.
Janitors. We'll get a fourth janitor. Do you want somebody stupid or somebody with dirty habits? Oh, new hire, natural mentor, and they can deal with ghosts. We'll get Tobias.
On 2 Point Radio.
Harrison Wolf here on 2 Point Radio. Remember, I'm not here to entertain you. I'm here to entertain myself.
Right. So, new illness, chest infection. Condition that causes hijinks and general buffoonery. Escape clowns must have their sense of humor completely excised to prevent a future relapse. We'll send them to the clown clinic. Watch somebody depress a clown. We've got four janitors, we've got one assistant, we've got four nurses and five doctors. But one of those doctors is just a researcher. So, get an extra doctor, shall we? Do we need one? Yeah, we could do it.
Toilets need routine servicing.
Litterer, and we'll work for Peanuts. Class clown and a litterer. Angry and high energy. Or charming, motivated. We'll get that one. Got Bart playing with a cannon. Mom, you're supposed to be fixing clowns. There we go. Watch Bart make this person depressed. He's not dead, but his treatment failed. Oh well.
Maintenance announcement. Bins
money is slowly going up. We just need to build a chromotherapy when we can. How much does chromotherapy cost? 21,100. Gotta wait a bit first.
You're listening to Harrison Wolf. I don't know what my time-traveling future self is up to, but my arm just disappeared.
A ghost has been sighted in the hospital.
Oh no, a ghost. Oh, that's not a funfair, that's for fixing people with clown problems. Let's have a look, can I send somebody to do it straight away? You are waiting for the GP. Send for treatment in the clown clinic. And you can see what happens. There's Bart coming to fix you as well. Yeah, it's absolute madness sometimes. And that is how you cure a clown. Maybe, did it work? It did. And he's back to normal. Oh, we even get an emergency for it. Yeah, we'll do it.
Clowns now arriving at the hospital.
They're going to come in on the helipad. Come on, where are you? Should be able to see all the sirens on your head. Oh no, they're all coming in out of one crown car. Oh, that's brilliant. That's brilliant. So, we can build a chromotherapy now.
Nurse needed in ward.
If you're unlucky enough to get sick, my advice, don't turn to Jumbo Medical Solutions. Their hospitals are well equipped, it's true. But what's the use of healing your body if you have to sell your soul, right?
What else can we add in here? Got a colorizer console. Keep forgetting the radiator. And then got fancy plasters.
Maintenance announcement. Plants need water.
And I need to put a new radiator in over here.
Plants
Yeah, there's some absolute mad stuff in this game. Like, this isn't even like halfway through either. We have the colorizer. We'll wait for somebody to pop up with that. Bart also seems to be the only nurse doing any work as well. Let's watch him fix somebody in the colorizer. Star Hospital. Congratulations, your hospital has been awarded a 1-star rating by the 2-point Health Ministry. It bodes well that your organisation has begun to dabble in research. Our initial notes suggested wrongly, it seems, that you weren't well suited to this particular task. Rest assured that whoever was responsible for such an off-the-mark remark will be losing their job forthwith. Unless it was me, of course, perish the thought. Continue with your studies for more awards, or go elsewhere and expand your organisation. So, we will continue here, because I am going to try and 3-star each hospital, even if I get 3-star off stream. So he wants us to cure 10 patients, we'll do that. I will promote you. But now is a perfect time to do some more training. So to get 2-star, we need to train 10 staff, generate 2,000 research, and cure 50 patients. So those two will just come with time, and then that we just need to spam training. So Manu, what are you researching? Fluid analysis is almost done. Let's do some more training, shall we? Psychiatry 3 for Sherry. You can have breaks. So, we're going to be building new rooms. We need more space. We really need more nurses. Yeah, the soundtrack for this game is great. Like, I love the adverts as well. Like, I think during one of the earlier things I saw during development, they said they took a lot of inspiration from Grand Theft Auto over how they wanted to do the radios and the music. So you get adverts, you get proper announcers, and they comment on stuff that's happening in the hospitals, that kind of thing. But the music is brilliant. New illness, night fever discovered. Our doctors have discovered a new illness, night fever. A psychiatric condition leading to spontaneous outbreaks of dancing, caused by prolonged exposure to mirror balls. We'll send the patient for treatment in our psychiatry. And we didn't cure enough of the clowns, we only cured one. This must be the person with night fever. Yeah, look at him. flares and everything. Right, so let's upgrade some more of these machines while we can. Upgrade you. Upgrade you. And we need to hire more nurses. So Frederick Noir has potential, loathes ordinal numbers. Barbara Goody, high energy but dull. Charlotte Cyanide is obviously going to try and murder people with a name like that. Motivated but nasty. And Rory McBoatface, inspiring but has a short temper. Yeah, we'll get this person with potential. Research complete, fluid analysis. We can build that now and we'll start off the next research. Make you a better researcher, shall we? So, fluid analysis, right there at the bottom. We need plant.
And we have plant. VIP visiting the hospital.
We need hand sanitizer. Yeah, I'll show you the ward in a second. I managed to get some upgraded beds for it. Bin. Always need a bin. Yeah, this is our ward here, where we've got pods instead of beds. So we got 5 grand for training, let's start off the next one. General practice 3 for Alex. Yeah, these pods are pretty handy, like they're slightly better than the regular beds and they're slightly easier to fit in as well. Ah, somebody's using the fluid room. Ah, they've already done it. And I forgot the radiator for that room because that nurse is cold. Oh no, he got stuck.
He was too old. They said he looked ridiculous. But when the world needs a hero.
There we go.
A hero must put on his spandex.
Right, let's watch what happens from the
this
start.
This summer, Roderick Cushion returns as Perilous Spandex. In. Perilous Spandex 5, a stretch too far. This is 2 Point Radio.
So, we have the fluid machine, it works quite well. What do we need to make the place prettier? Some more plants. Plants everywhere. I think it's about time we got that second assistant as well. So, assistants, we have girl next door, put a customer service, motivated, yes, you will do. What other staff do we have? So those are our doctors, with Sherry the psychiatrist, Alex the GP, Manu the researcher, nurses with Lizzie Psycho the nurse, the psychiatrist, two assistants, four janitors. Splash out an extra janitor. Charming wants more money and can deal with ghosts, who will do. Injection room required, you can go home, we don't have an injection room yet. Staff training required, you will have to wait. Or have you not seen the injection room yet, Manu? We shall go back and watch for when somebody turns up. New illness, Freudian lips discovered. Our doctors have discovered a new illness, Freudian lips. A tendency to pout excessively when faced with a camera caused by a buildup of lewd faults in the cerebral cortex. The psychiatrist must use a subconscious tap to drain excess thoughts into a beaker, after which they can be safely disposed of in an incinerator. Seems like we need to send Sherry for that. So I will watch for somebody coming over to the injection room so you can see it. Or the fluid room. If you are currently researching how to become a better researcher, but we will do the injection room after that. Publicity update.
Plants need water.
Performing to an adequate standard. He wants us to improve. I'm just not that impressed. So, got those. Time for more bench spam. News agents in, shall we? Now we need an assistant to work there. So you are good at customer services and you're dull. Thanks for the donation, Starnex. A lot.
Pharmacy, calling nurse.
All going to a good cause.
Claims the song you just heard was composed in outer space, somewhere around the second moon of Jupiter. That's the small one. You probably never heard it. Adrastia. Of course, maybe they just drank too many cans of palpitation.
Right, what else can we train people on? let's make Bart a better better pharmacist, shall we?
Doctor to research, please.
So, pharmacy trainee. So we need to find him. Courses. Let's train him in the injection room. We don't quite have it yet, but. He means he will be ready, trained to use it when we can.
Nurse required in cardiology.
How many nurses do we have, or are they just all on break? Yeah, we could probably do with another nurse. We got high energy but terribly dull, unmotivated and but it's a natural mentor, lazy, has potential and class clown. You will do. Check how the hospital looks. That's just because the plant's wilting a bit.
Maintenance announcement. Bins will become full.
Tell you what, let's stick one of the janitors just watering plants. You, because you have the least qualifications, so you'll be best for it. We want these three grading and doing ghosts when they can. But now you are plant alterer.
Maintenance announcement. Automated sand machines need restocking manually.
Rubbish. There we go.
So I have a new hobby now. Beekeeping. I only have 3 bees for now. Not as easy to catch as you'd think, but I'm looking forward to all that sweet, sweet honey. And here's a sweet, sweet melody for you all.
Patients now arriving for the ward.
Right, out of the ward, these guys arrive. We're gonna get a helicopter this time. We are. There's the emergency helicopter. Daisy Tycart is now a proper nurse, not just a junior nurse. So, what else do we want? Get, make Jasper better in the ward, shall we? And let's see if we can do any other upgrades in the meantime. You can be upgraded. You can be upgraded. Plants fix everything.
Calling nurse.
There we go, that's plenty of plants now. And we seem to be alright for the radiator. Is there anywhere we can crank it up as a whole? I know in the theme hospital there was. Overview. Cube running length, let's pop you up a bit. The diagnosis up to 100. Cost of treatments. For loans.
I don't often do this, but here's the weather report. A purple contentment seeps through the pores of Krakenbush. A vast cloud of inexperienced crows gathers for the annual feast over flattering. And finally, the
increase
tears
the temperature
of a cloud
swirl
to a tide down the streets of Grockle Bay.
Weird.
The next weather report will
be in 17
years.
I've sworn there was a way to do it. Either that or I've just forgotten. Looking in the wrong place or something. Staff challenge, go 90 days without a death. Unlikely, but we'll try it. Be finishing in a couple of minutes. What I'll do is I'll get this hospital up to 2 and 3 star off stream. So we'll save this one here. But before I do, I will show you our previous hospital that we got to 3 star, because I just realised I never showed that. This was Flottering, where we were learning about staff development and training. And this is what level 3 of it looks like. And then we'll all raid on over to Alex. So this is level 3 at Flottering. And you can see how packed the hospital is here once you've got it to 3 star. So we have multiple GP rooms. Got another 2 GP rooms over here. Another ward, another psychiatrist. Even an extra reception just to deal with all the extra patients coming in and out. You can see how busy it gets once you go up the stars rating. So I've got 2 of almost every room, along with the world's biggest toilets, just because everybody needed the toilet at one point. The world's biggest toilets. I've got 2 wards, one which is specifically for, I think this is the diagnosis one, so people only do diagnosis here, and this ward only does treatment. You can see there I've set it. You can also set extra staff in the wards as well, so they both always have 2 nurses in. But yeah, this is the 3-star ward, or 3-star hospital, with God knows how many patients and stuff in there, and the queues are still massive. Even though I've got 4 fully trained GPs and 4 rooms, like 4 GPs' offices. And yeah, to get it to 3 stars, you really have to organise stuff and like tweak it a bit and make sure it's all, use up as much space as the best you can. So I will get to 3 stars with the training hospital that we've just been on, and I will get that, like, next stream I will go back to that hospital to show it you again, so you can see what that one looks like at 2 and 3 stars. But all of this is a lot of just like tweaking and moving little bits, and like having to tweak all the staff's breaks and stuff to make sure you've got enough people on at the right time. And you still end up with deaths. But yeah, this is a level 3 hospital. So Alex is online now, and he's doing Spider-Man Miles Morales. So we will be raiding over to him. Thank you for coming, everybody. I'll be back again on Saturday doing more carrion. And I'm reliably informed I am towards the end of that game now. So I'll be working out what game to do next, but I have a couple of ideas.
Come on.
So we'll discuss it on that stream, I think.
Awesome.
It just depends how far we get in carrion.
Into your life with probability, the drink that rolls the dice of life. Probability? What's the worst that can happen? 24 hours a day.
So,
probability. What's the worst
we've
that
all
can happen?
Raid on over to Alex. Yeah, I am so slowly getting better at this. We've all. So I will see you all soon. Bye, everybody. And I hope to see you all on Saturday.